The simple way that I described, where we used photographs or film to take two pictures, if you will, of the same center with a time break in intervals. So when you put them on a stereo microscope, there's a time difference, and anything, all the stars line up or coincide, and anything that's moving, you will see a shift, and you will see an elevation of one image over the other, a rubbery effect. What we've done then, as soon as we've measured those, now you will get a lot of trailing if something is typically very close. So, and usually, but even if intrinsically the asteroid is rather faint, but if it's very close to the Earth, it looks very bright. The first one I ever found, my estimate was 10th magnitude. And why was it 10th magnitude? It was because it was very close to the Earth and a long trail, and it was heading south and to the southern hemisphere. And we waited kind of breathlessly for about 5 days, and of all things, Wellington, New Zealand recovered it, some friends of mine at Carter Observatory. So that was a lot of excitement, because there were so many days we didn't have follow-up observations. Chile thought they saw it, but they didn't get the observations or the measurements in. So, I mean, these sort of events happen. Typically what will get your attention in the old method of searching for these objects is the length of the trail, which shows that it's moving fast and it's typically close to the Earth. Now we are using charge-coupled devices, CCD, cameras on the focal plane of Schmidt telescopes, and what they do, we take short exposures, 20 seconds, and then we go back to the same center three times, and then those are stacked together by the software, and then anything that lines up, the stars will all coincide. Anything that doesn't drops out, and you get the motion for maybe 35, 40 minutes. And so you have three positions. And so right away, you have a little arc, an observing arc for that object. And our software also has written to identify with our parameters objects of certain motion. How does it compare with the rest of the main belt asteroids? Is it strange or different compared to other known types or near-Earth asteroids? So it actually identifies our what we call intra